All right, so now I just did a restart of the software. It was my bad. In the end, it was my bad because I decided to connect the headphones live because I didn't have any issues doing that on OBS, but apparently here that's an issue. So yeah, let's go back to where we left. Unfortunately, I lost that game that I was playing, but let's see how we fare now that we don't have that whole lagging situation that was going on before. I don't know why I'm putting so many credits because I'm just gonna play one game.
It's yours.
So whether Almaru gets his ass kicked or not, actually, you know what? I'm gonna play with Denjiro. I'll be the. You guys didn't leave. Let me check to see if I'm actually live again. See if everything is working here. Yep, everything seems to be working fine now. Let's hope that it lasts. All right, let's do this. I know I had to test this a little bit more thoroughly. All right. Oh shit! Perfect. Damn. She could have done that. Ha! Rolling rice. Welcome, buddy. Damn, bro. And I think you missed on the first two shoot 'em ups, man. I was doing Graceful Explosion, but I had to restart a few times, so it's all good. Because since I'm using different software than OBS to do the stream, I'm still working out through some kinks. But hopefully the change in software will be a change in quality, both as you can see by the webcam. It's showing up in a better quality. The sound should be a lot better, and the video, of course. Hopefully it won't be compressed to hell like the other streams. Yes, that's one of the things I showed it off here. This one in particular, since you can set it up pressing the, so you can check it out right here. That's B1. That's A5, which has a more intense scan line. But the B2 I like because the B2 has the little subtle scan lines, but it also has the scrolling lines going up and down, kind of like the arcade, which is awesome. So yeah. And you have the option for a wider screen. Wider than, it's not a stretching mechanism. Let's do it. Let me get him. Oh, I lost the chance. Oh shit. Armada's getting. Not good, not good. Oh, got me. Thank you. Just like I said, I just went a little too far by allowing the 60 frames per second option on the Twitch stream. That messed everything up. And my little shenanigans of connecting the headphones messed up the audio, making the system freeze for the very first time. Sorry, Galford, but you were starting to get on my fucking nerves. Yeah, a little root beer, for lack of the real thing. Now, Glowing Rice, now that I got Glowing Rice and Paul Winchester, if you guys haven't seen that Nintendo Direct, what do you guys think of Cinemora EX? Oh man, I gotta get that game. I gotta get that game. That's gonna be a 2-hour stream for sure. God! What the? Gotcha! Fatality, baby. Oh no! I didn't kill her! Oh shit! I didn't kill her! Got me. Got me for sure. Refresh it, dude. Refresh it. Let me see something. Yeah, I'm still going. Holy crap. I'm getting my ass handed by this. Nope, not good. Oh, that's it. Game over. Game over. That's it. Kick my ass. Now, I don't know. Probably the stream is going to be broken up into different parts because of the times that I've had to restart. Now, I'm going to play one more. Oh, shit. I'm going to play one more as Homaru, and then that's it. I'll go to the next game, because if not, I'll just stay here playing this. I can play this, like, forever. That's it. Yeah, Twitch is going through a lot of shit. It's becoming more and more of an app and Amazon and a whole bunch of other crazy stuff. I'm going to monitor Hitbox to see how they're doing over there. Because if this crap keeps up, I'm gonna probably permanently move over to Hitbox. Because I know for sure that the settings, at least the quality settings, I can bump it up much, much higher than I do in Twitch. For sure, brother. For sure. I'm going to play this one, and then I'm going to go and play for you. Because I don't know if you made it here on time. Did you get to check the other the shoot-em-ups? I did Alpha Mission 2, and I did Graceful Explosion Machine. Gotcha. Come on, come at me, girl. Got him really good. Check it out. Speed it up here a little bit.
Iza jinjouni, ippon me.
Cool. Yes, it does, my friend. Right here, you go, you press the start button, and you go into game settings. And you go to violence, and it has all the levels. Has level 1 to 3 with and without the special commands, like for the really fatalities, basically. I have it at level 3 with the commands. Oh, yeah. They have them, all right. So that means that you can play the American version just like the Japanese and vice versa, which is awesome. No censorship bullshit here, man. I got him with a punch in the knee. And this is not even my favorite one, man. My favorite one is Samurai Shodown 5 Special. Because of the blood and gore, because of the massive amount of characters you can use, it's basically the pinnacle of Samurai Shodown on the Neo Geo. And I think, and I need to be corrected if I'm wrong, I believe it's the biggest, or the largest, Neo Geo cart in terms of megs or size. Oh my god, this character is fucking annoying. Get off of me. Oh my god, she killed me with an umbrella to the ankle. Can you believe that shit? Come on! Use the move! Well, you guys saw it. I got killed by a guy in an umbrella. Oh yeah, I don't doubt that it will eventually appear. That's something that's a given. The thing is, like I mentioned before, guys. I mean, Hamster has here a license to print money because they know that a lot of us who got the Switch are basically hardcore retro gamers in many aspects. They know that. So they release little by little, which I agree. I think it was you, yeah, Glowing Rays, that said it was better a compilation. Yeah, it's true. But of course they make much more money if they sell them individually. Now, I don't mind buying them individually as long as they put the care that they put on these titles. Right now, $7.99 is a bit steep for Neo Geo titles. when you consider the pricing on the virtual console of past, let's say past consoles like Wii and Wii U, it's kind of steep. However, I feel that the transition to this platform has been very graceful. They added a tons of features, filter, violence. They even did a second day patch which fixed the colors, because the colors were kind of washed out, and they came right through and they said, no, this was a bug, we're gonna fix it. Boom, a patch, and now it's very colorful, just like the arcade. So I don't mind paying for them. What I do get pissed off, and I need to get on the soapbox here for a second, is the fact that they know that people are going to be starving for titles in the beginning of the launch. So they start releasing, let's say, the not so popular versions of the series, of different series like Metal Slug. The first one they came out with was Metal Slug 3. Now, you know, you don't need to be a genius. Metal Slug 3 was not the most popular of the series. So they released that one because they figured everybody is crazy to download something. So they're going to buy this one. And when the favorite one appears, they're going to buy that one too. Which I believe that's kind of like a shitty tactic, to be honest. I understand the business aspect of it, because they don't want to for some titles to sell and others don't. But come on, don't sucker your customers, because you're gonna get some bad will out of your customers, the paying customers. So at least, at the very least, they did not made me wait 2 or 3 months for a Samurai Showdown, and they could have done a lot worse, because they could have released the first one, which of course is it's the most popular one in terms that it came out on every single fucking platform in existence, but it wasn't the best one. Of course, 2 is much more feature-packed, but I would say that my favorite in the series would be 2, and then jump. I wouldn't mind skipping 3 and 4 and just go, not even 5 special. That's it. That's basically it. You have 2 and you have 5. That's it. The rest, they did some tweaks and stuff, like that one-hit kill stuff. It's kind of cool in Mortal Kombat, but for Samurai Showdown, it really didn't have a place. They tweaked that and they took it out. Good for them. So that's why 3 and 4 were really, really not that good. The characters were kind of cool. So in 5 Special, basically, you get all the fixes. You get all the button placements that they started fucking around with the placements, like the strong strike and stuff like that. They messed around completely with that. And in 5 Special, they fix everything. Plus, you have the full roster. Plus, you have all the violence and gore. I'm sold. That's it. That's the definitive version for me, in my opinion. Now, since you came in a little late, I'm throwing it out there for Glowing Rice. What do you want me to play for you here, out of the stuff that I got? And I'll just do that, because I already covered, before you came in, I covered a little bit of Graceful Explosion. I covered Alpha Mission 2. Did I do RMX? No, I didn't do RMX. And now I did Samurai Showdown. So you let me know. What do you want to check out from what I got here? I know it's not much, but all right, cool beans. I know the other guys won't mind, because either I haven't seen them in the chat for a while, either they're not there, or they don't really mind. Y'all gamers and stuff, and I really didn't play much of Alpha Mission the first time around when I started the stream. And now that it's working, that the stream is working, I'll probably use this one as the video that I'm going to be uploading to YouTube. Since this one it seems to be going without a hitch, everything is working fine. So yeah, let's do this. Ah, you saw Shock Trooper, huh? Yep. And that's the thing, Anthony, which is a Neo Geo Master Jedi here, he hasn't come around yet. But I know that when he sees the video, he's gonna freak out, because it has Neo Geo titles. He he's not here, and as you can see, you want to see Neo Geo games. Oh, Aaron is going to do Lego City Undercover. That's something worth checking out. So you guys check that out later if you have time. I'm going to go for... I don't see that being too far off, dude. I mean, if they announce... If they announce a virtual console, which shouldn't be too far off, you know for a fact that TurboGrafx is going to be part of that. Of course, I'm hoping that the titles that we do get, or that they get priority, is GameCube titles. But I wouldn't mind having some more TurboGrafx fun here. But again, it all depends on pricing too, man. Because if they're gonna charge $8 a pop, I don't see myself getting them. I already have Hyperspan and 2,000 ways of playing these titles in a much better, let's say, environment. The only reason for me to pick it up here would be to have them portable. That's the whole thing, have them portable. And even so, I can hack the 3DS and run emulators on it, so they need to make it enticing, and I already got my ass kicked. I confess, I haven't played this game as much as I would like to. And I'm easily distracted for some reason. I just get my ass kicked. See if I can focus a little bit. Alright, let's get the laser. No. Well, I wouldn't see the practicality of bringing the Neo Geo to the virtual console for now, because I think that would go against what Hamster is doing, which is setting them individually. So I'm guessing that Neo Geo platform is out of the equation for now. I'm guessing. So if we see some systems that I would love to see on the virtual console would be Saturn games, man. We need to have Saturn. Saturn and, dare I say, Dreamcast, maybe? I mean, it has the power to run them. No doubt. Even if the titles are a bit higher, I wouldn't mind paying them. To play Power Stone and play... Oh my god, so many freaking titles from the Dreamcast on a virtual console would be amazing. But, if we cannot go as high as Dreamcast, at least bring the Saturn. It would be a perfect complement to GameCube titles if they ever make it to the virtual console. You dying? You're supposed to die. Whoa! Now two titles that really caught me off guard from the Nintendo Direct was, of course, Payday 2. And I know I'm not the only one feeling that way. But I saw in that little trailer, I saw the potential of the system. And the potential, what I mean by potential, is the potential of getting ports of really, really high quality modern games, you know, with modern graphics through the system. And if they play the internet cards right, I think that game's gonna be fun as fuck online. I know Payday is not an Uncharted level in terms of graphics, but hey, compared to what we've seen from Nintendo in the past, it's pretty good. And we still need to see what they have in the works with Rare, because I know Rare has been gone like for the past 5 or 6 years in some mountain working on something for the system. So I'm hoping we see. I'm getting my ass kicked. Let me go ahead and do you the solid of throwing in here Shock Troopers. Ah, it's a pity, man. It's a real pity. Damn. I hope it gets better somehow, because I know it has to do with the internet, because so far on my side everything is working fine. Ever since I changed that, I restarted the stream with the 30 frames per second instead of 60. Everything is working fine now, at least on my side. So I know it must be something with the internet speed that's causing all kinds of havoc on your side. But I appreciate it a lot that you actually came over. And I love having you guys on my stream and stuff, and everybody else who's watching as well. Since I haven't been able to do this with the frequency that I would love to, the way I did it before, just looking for something that'll give me a video quality that's good enough, so the video doesn't get compressed to hell. I'm gonna make the test now when I upload to YouTube. Let's do Milky and Big Mama. No? Can I choose Big Mama? And let's go Rally. Oh yeah. Woohoo! Stuck? What happened, Aaron, that you got stuck in Iron System? I figured you'd be done with that game by now. No! Nope, I need something. Somebody. Faster. software, bad luck. It's the software I'm using for the first time, actually. The software that came bundled with my capture card, which is Rec Central. Never used it before because it was pretty sucky when I first got the capture card. It was version 1.0 and it looked nice, but in practice it was pretty limited. Now they came out with different versions of 2.0, which is the one that I'm using right now. I gotta say, the quality of the video, which is what I was looking for, something to upgrade the, so my video wouldn't get as compressed as with OBS. Have you streamed the I Am Setsuna stuff? Have you streamed it so I can check it out? Yeah, it's like I said, bad luck. Like I said to the guys, I'm gonna check and see how Hitbox is doing. If they've always been a bit better with the settings and stuff for Hitbox, and you know that. You guys used to go over there when I do the shoot 'em up specials. Everything would work fine, you know. It would be a lot better than over here. I did come back to Twitch because, to be honest, I had more followers over here, and it's kind of easier for people to get on. But it's like you say, man, it's just too many shit. Everything is getting so cluttered, and everything is being hidden behind a paywall, which is fucking absurd. That's it. I'm going to show you guys real quick, and I'll be ending it with that. I'm going to show you guys real quick Snake Pass. Probably end the stream with this one. I wanna go ahead, and since I still don't know if I'm gonna be working tonight, I just wanna get everything ready, upload this to YouTube, and get my ass to playing Zelda again. Cause it is gonna be my last chance before the crazy week starts again. I gotta be working 8 to 12 hours, sometimes 6 to 7 days a week. That's why, like I told Anthony, I really wish that I could do this more often. And you can bet that I will. I will do it more than I'm doing it right now. Now, one of the things that I want to stream for you guys, because I want to test this software with the PC games. I still haven't figured out how to do that yet, because this is basically a capture card for consoles. I'm going to see if I add a video source, and if it does work, I'll probably be doing the Bayonetta for PC that came out. Plus, there's a ton of games that I have there that I haven't played for you guys. Resident Evil 7, Deus Ex, that if it runs with a better video quality, you can bet that I'm going to be doing at least one stream a week and maybe one or two recordings using this stuff. So that way I can keep myself more relevant. Let's see how it works out. Yep. So you're probably gonna see me. If you go in today, Glowing Rice, you're gonna see me online. I always see you around when it shows the friends online. You're always there when I'm playing Zelda. So yeah. All right. What can I say about this game? All I can say about this game is damn. This game, as you saw by the intro, it uses Unreal 4. This is the first title that even though it's not really, really out there in terms of graphics complexity, it's an indie title, obviously, at heart. And it has kind of toony graphics. However, there's a lot of effects going on, as you're going to see. Even though if it looks a little bit like Rayman Legends, there's a lot going under the hood on this title, and it gives us a very good idea of what to expect later on with other Unreal titles, Unreal Engine 4 titles. Now, I read an article the other day, I think it was yesterday, that there are over 20 titles, Unreal Engine 4 titles, coming for the Switch. Most of them are Japanese, which I don't mind at all. Now, a lot of people complaining that there are not a lot of Western AAA titles that uses the engine. I don't care. I don't give a fuck. I prefer the Japanese developers over the Western, because the Western developers, all that they have given us for years is fucking bullshit DLC and fucking paywalls and fucking repetitive gameplay and gouging us for a whole bunch of shit. Don't even make me talk. So, yeah, I want some more Japanese games. All for it, and indie titles, of course, because I'm seeing not a resurgence, because indie titles have been growing the past few years. But what I'm seeing, what I told Bad Luck yesterday, was we're seeing indie titles that are becoming the Capcom and the Konami, and you know what third parties used to be back in the day. These are the new companies. These are the ones that are going to take place over the big corporate bullshit that is going on in the gaming industry. So yeah, you see companies like Sumo Digital doing this game, and you see the potential of, again, gameplay over graphics mantra that has been like what has produced the best games for the 8 and 16-bit era. So here we are, guys. This is it. Welcome to my snake. Do you like my snake? my head is wobbly. So you have a button to make them move, to make them go forward, sorry, and then you have the controller. You have one of the controller is for camera movement. As you can see, there's a lot going on. It reminds me a lot of the Rare games back in the day. You can see some reflection going on there. Now this is all physics based. There is no hand holding in this game. Either you learn the mechanics or you die. That's basically it. Like, you have a button to move forward, but if you leave him like that, he's gonna go very slow. In order for you to pick up speed, you need to go, you're going like a snake, side to side, so he picks up speed. And that's the way you have to traverse the obstacles that you find. There's no shortcut, no easy button, easy mode. No, you have to either learn how to do it or die. Again, I'm sorry I'm being repetitive, but that's what it is. So you see here, if you want to get on top of that, you need to move around. Which I have to admit, it's pretty hard, but it's pretty difficult. I'm not going to mention the word hard with snake, because sensory. Now there's a button, I forgot, okay, the A button, this makes you go up. You need to wrap yourself around in order to get to higher places. And of course you have the little birdie, which can pick your tail up and help you in certain places. I make them, okay, there you go. Ah, that would be nice. I still got to get in order all my collection so I can do a stream. I promised to do a stream on that series, and I haven't yet. There's some coins and shit that you need to pick up here, but most of them are so, like, hanging from the walls and stuff like that, that you really need to master the controls in order to pick them up. Okay, so the object here is to find a keystone. So let's go. The missing keystone. Oh my god, yeah. Come on. Ah! There we go. You know I'm gonna fall. No, I'm gonna fall. I think there's a coin hanging from there somewhere. Now the music is a little bit on the elevator music side of things, admittedly, but you know, it's the least cool of basically the whole package, which is awesome. I just, you know, mute the music and throw on some heavy metal and that's it, you're set. Now I need to point out that this game, as good as it looks, they did, because Digital Foundry, as much as they are like the de facto right now, current de facto of tech and stuff like that, to me they are stealth trolls on everything Nintendo, but that's just me. The first day that this game came out and they went with the comparison videos to compare it with the PlayStation version, and they were talking smack about how it was lacking certain effects and stuff. And what did Sumo Digital do? They did a first day patch, basically making their report and comparison obsolete right there and there. So there you go. That's what happens to you for being a fucking troll. I mean, the update, the patch did not make it equal to the PlayStation 4 version. That would be basically impossible. However, the missing features and graphical effects that they were pointing out very trollishly that were missing, Sumo Digital just did a first day patch, boom, and you got them. That's the cool thing about being able to use the Unreal Engine 4, because the Unreal Engine 4 right now is being worked in a way where it even has a Switch mode. When you look into the software, it has an actual Switch mode that if you want to convert a project, all you have to do is activate the Switch mode and all the assets are going to be, you know, work for that platform. So, except for Unity, I haven't seen that level of accommodation to Nintendo platform before. Ah. That speaks very well for future games. Now, to be honest, this character though, the snake, I don't know if it's just me, but he looks like he's drunk, man. You look at him, yeah. Ah, ah, oh, ah, ah. Hey, he looks like he's fucking drunk. Yeah, guys, basically that's the way it works for Snake Pass. It's a pretty awesome title, indie title. As you can see by the controls, it's very good, very accommodated for this controller, the Pro Controller, which by the way has been awesome so far. Tons of hours of charge, hasn't left me, you know, hanging even once, never disconnected me from a game. Every time that I haven't necessarily had to stop a game in order to put it to charge or connect the cable when I'm gaming. Usually I notice when I'm going to put the system away if it needs any charge, and I just connect it to the dock and that's it. So this is Snake Pass. I'm gonna close it up here. And yeah, there's plenty to play. Let me throw one race here. And with this, I will with one race here, I'll say goodbye for now. I've done plenty. I mean, this last segment has been going on for almost an hour, so it'll make a nice little upload for you. Fast RMX.
Subsonic.
Hopefully, this is a title I wanted to test with this software, because given the high-end graphics and the speed of it, I want to see how good it renders the video, or if it compresses it a lot like OBS, which in that case, if it does the same thing, I'll probably end up using OBS again. But hopefully it won't.
Argon.
Now this stage, I haven't tried it out yet. I want to test it.
Exile GmbH.
Let's do this.
Welcome to Iceland.
This up and go here to the cam scene. So yeah, guys, basically I have a shoot 'em up in store for you guys. It's all I can say is that it's a huge, huge shoot 'em up. It's a classic series. However, it is completely revamped for the modern age with modern HD graphics. It has a whole bunch of DLC, which I'm not even gonna bother getting half of because it's crazy. But the main game I will have, and I will find a way to stream it in the best quality ever, because it's just, I saw it on Steam and it drove me nuts. So stay tuned for that. Shoot 'em up fans like Glowing Rice and Paul Winchester, I'm going to bring in more of that later on. Thank you guys for being here. Thanks for being patient and allowing me to test run this software, which I think I'm going to be using from now on because I'm liking what I see. So yeah, hopefully I'll see you guys next time. Take care and keep on gaming, guys. See ya. Peace.